Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Teresa Lopez, and I'll be presenting on factors shaping the airborne microbial community in olive orchards and its relationship with endophytes from two cultivars dissimilarly susceptible to the pest Bactrocella oli. First and foremost, I would like to say that the olive fruit fly is the most important insect pest of the olive crops worldwide, being responsible to cause drastically decreases in the crop yield. These losses are normally due to the pulp destruction caused by the larvae in the fruit, premature fruit drop, and reduction on the oil quality. In olive orchards located in the Tussos Montes region, northeast of Portugal, it has been found that under the same agronomic and edaphoclimatic conditions, different olive cultivars exhibit different propensities to the fruit fly infestation. For instance, the cultivar Cobranzosa is less susceptible to the olive fruit fly infestation than the cultivar Madurell. Here, we want to disclose the role of biotic and abiotic factors in shaping the olive airborne microbial community, and so is to assess the importance of the air as source of fruit endophytes. Especially, we ask the following questions. Does orchard management system, host cultivar, and canopy position shape the airborne microbial community? Is the air a source of olive fruit endophytes? Well, to achieve these objectives and answer these questions, the airborne and endophytic microbial community of infested fruits from cultivars Madurell and Cobranzosa were studied in two olive orchards under organic and integrated pest management. The air samples were collected from the interior and the exterior part of the tree canopy, and the culture-dependent approach was used, being the isolates identified by sequencing of the internal transfer spacer for the fungi and the 16S region for the bacteria. As we can see, the airborne bacterial community of the olive tree was found to be less diverse compared to the fungal community. And the bacterial community was mostly composed of the members of the phyla Actinobacteria and Tenericutis and the genera Mycoplasma and Cotinobacteria, which was previously reported in some woody plants such as Platanus hispanica. As for the fungal community, it was dominated by members of the phylum Ascomycota and the genera Cladosporium, Alternaria and Penicillium. The prevalence of these fungi in different environments have been reported extensively. Although all biotic and abiotic factors had negligible effects on the airborne bacterial community composition, the type of management and host cultivar significantly influenced the structure of the entire airborne fungal community, explaining 9.8 and 6.9% of the fungal community variation respectively. The difference in the fungal diversity and composition among the type of management could be due to the prevailing environmental conditions caused by the different inputs, particularly the fertilizers and the pesticides used in the IPM and the organic management. And the observed influence of the host cultivar in the airborne fungal composition could be related to the differences on the epiphytic fungal community between the two cultivars surveyed. Actually, as a matter of fact, studies have indicated that the epiphytes are considered to be the most important local source of the airborne fungal. Overall, the results show that the airborne fungal and the bacterial communities are actually not driven by the same factors. But despite this, it was found a clear positive association of the airborne microbial consortium with the resistant cultivar, Cobranzosa. In our study, the air surrounding the olive tree canopy seems not to be the most important source of fruit endophytes due to the reduced similarities found in the microbial composition between the air and the fruit endosphere. Besides the air, other important sources of endophytes of above ground plant organs include the soil, the rain, the wind, the pollinators, and other insects. Another relevant aspect that must be considered in this work is the possible endophytic transmission via olive fruit fly. Besides its potential role as a factor of endophytes, the opposition wounds of the olive fruit fly may also favor endophytic colonization of the fruit. And since olive tree is often propagated from cuttings, there is also a strong possibility for vertical transmission of endophytes. But all these assumptions are still need to be confirmed with further studies. With this work, we can conclude that the airborne microbial composition was not affected by the same factors, and the type of management and host cultivar only influenced the fungal composition, having no effect on the bacterial community. The reduced similarities found on the microbial composition between the air and the fruit endosphere suggests that the air is not the most important source of the fruit endophytes. Thank you so much for your attention. I deeply appreciate it.